Let us now discuss reverse biasing. First, we'll discuss this reverse biasing with the help of a realistic situation. Here you can see this picture shows a PN junction connected to a battery. And here we can see that P side of the junction is connected to the negative or low potential side of the battery, and N side of the junction is connected to the positive or high potential side of the battery, which we term as reverse biasing. And here when we close down the switch, you can see that the electric field established by the battery is in the same direction of the internal electric field, due to which the barrier potential or the junction voltage further increases, and this electric field further displaces the holes of P side toward left and electrons of N side toward right, because electric field exerts force on negative charges in the direction opposite to it, and it exerts a force on positive charges in the direction of the field. And due to which here we can see that the depletion layer width is increased, and no flow of charge carrier takes place in this situation. So we can see the current in the circuit will be negligible. However, we know that in P side there are some minority carrier electrons, and on the N side there are some minority carrier holes. A minor or a very minute current flows through the junctions due to minority carriers, which we are not representing here, because the current due to this is negligible. And here about this reverse biasing, we can write that in reverse biasing, external potential difference increases the barrier potential difference, and both sides of junction, electrons and holes are pulled in direction away from depletion layer, and due to which we can see the width of layer increases and the current is negligible. Here we can see in this symbolic circuit diagram that if a PN junction diode is reverse biased, that is, its P side is connected to negative terminal of battery and N side is connected to positive terminal of battery. Here you can see on closing the switch, a negligible current flows through the circuit, and this current is almost of the range of microampere, which can be neglected here.